I grew up in Thessaloniki until about I was 14 years old. Thessaloniki then was beautiful.
Well, that's where my late father went there in 1922 when he left Asia Minor. That's where they gave us the house in exchange for what we lost in Turkey. And that's where I was born in 1945.
Yes, another exhibition with the famous town of Thessaloniki. Not only a beautiful city, it's also a cultural city. I love Thessaloniki because Thessaloniki is near to my hometown, Alexandroupolis. It's a Byzantine ancient Greek town, but with its colorful town, with history, with religious, because it's too close to Mount Athos, and it's very spiritual city. One of the best cities, I think, of the Balkans and of the Europe, of course.
The exhibition provides a window to the soul of the city and the soul of the Greek people. The heart of Greece is the struggle for freedom, the struggle to reinvent themselves in the modern age, to incorporate their ancient roots together with being a modern nation state. And the exhibition helps remind us of that, remind us of the people who lived that struggle, who lived those moments of trying to define who they were as they sought to win their freedom and define themselves in the 20th century and beyond.
Hey, Vaughan's father
was living in these tents.
Well, this, Vaughan's father.
Yeah. As a from Asia Minor. In 1922.
See, the Greeks, Guinness.
What happened was, at that time, the Armenians and Pontians started to arrive because they were all living in Turkey. And the persecution of the Armenians started exactly at that time, in the year 8, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Mm-hmm. And they was going into the diaspora, around. And then come the Pontians. The Pontians were Alexander the Great's descendants. They were the pure Greeks, right? Yes. And their dialect
the Spartans.
Talking about Macedonians.
The Spartans are pure Greeks.
The Spartans are pure Greeks.
I
think Salonika is a city for everybody. It was founded by the Greeks in ancient times by Alexander the Great's brother-in-law, Kassandos, king of Macedonia, named after Alexander the Great's sister, Thessaloniki. It's part of the modern Greek state, yet it's been home over the ages to multiple peoples. It's been home to Ottomans, to Pontian Greeks from Asia Minor, to Sephardic Jews seeking religious tolerance in their fleeing from the Spanish Inquisition, to Bulgarians, to Serbs, to Russians. It's been home to Vlachs, to all peoples. So while it is part of the modern Greek state, and as its heart and soul is Greek, I think culturally it can be called an international city belonging to many peoples.
It is the jewel in the crown of Greece. Whoever passed from Salonika fell in love with her. People, history, perfumes, culinary delights, beliefs, the osmosis of people. This is a crossroads, you know, which fertilizes the north. And without the north, Greece cannot be the same. So I'm happy to be given the opportunity to inaugurate this exhibition. Very humbly, I say congratulations, because it is a selection of very beautiful photographs. What I have to say is congratulations to the Hellenic Club.
This photographic exhibition came to Australia last year, just before Christmas, by the Ministry of Northern Greece, who kindly agreed that we could bring this exhibition to Canberra. Unfortunately, not many people who visit Greece visit Thessaloniki. And I hope that tonight's exhibition will entice some of these people next time they go to Greece to visit this beautiful city, known also as the second capital of Greece, and the mother of all nationalities.
Greek Australians and our Philippine Australian friends today have the opportunity with this beautiful exhibition to remember and pay tribute to this historical anniversary. I'm very happy, ευχαριστώ πολύ κύριε Καζάν, because I know that you paid, as always, a very diligent and meticulous effort to put this exhibition in place. And you cannot imagine how important it is for us Greeks overseas, members of the diaspora, to remember and to honor. Ευχαριστώ πολύ.